Hi, this is Teddy from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're going to do the full review of a knife that I did a pretty extensive unboxing and first impression with a lot of kind of background information about the company and the makers behind it and how these knives were made. And now I had it for quite a bit of time, I carried and used it, and I have some final thoughts to give about the knife, also cover the specs and everything like you're used to from my full reviews. And as you can see by all the packaging here on the table, we're talking about the Hog House knives and their first model, which is the Model T. That is this knife right here. This is a Finnish made CNC custom knives, a bit of custom to, for example, Holt Blade Works or Grimsmo knives, Skiff blades, just things like that. It is a bit in this kind of vein that they produce the knives in terms of the machines they use. They use a Haas CNC. They started off their knife making in a pig farm in Finland. And in the meantime, they have now transitioned into a more modern facility where they can build their knives a bit better. And they also have released a second model now that is called the Veli, which is a quite larger model that also has a blade cut out and is actually the design of Viljami Salonen. This one, the Model T, as marked on the lock bar here, is of course design of Tapio Syrjälä. These two Finnish knife makers and goldsmiths are the guys behind Hog House knives, and the name of course comes from the original pig farm where they started their journey in knife making. The company was founded in 2021, and this is one of their earlier models. This is actually number 140 of their Model T's. And they really don't stop evolving. If you check out their Instagram, which I highly would recommend, you really see that they always keep evolving. At the moment, for example, they have a very cool titanium finish available that is called crystallized titanium. Very, very gorgeous full titanium frame finishes that have a bit of a crystallized look, and those are available in different colors as well. And they do a lot of the stuff here in-house, all the milling. They do their own bearings, which are ceramic bearings in a kind of polymer casing. They, of course, CNC grind their blades. This one is in M390. They also do knives in RWL34. And just absolutely gorgeous stuff and some very unique kind of Nordic-inspired overall designs that we get here from Tapio Syrjälä and Viljami Salonen. And let's take a look at the specs here of the Hog House knives Model T in this full review. So we are getting an overall length of the Model T of 19.5 centimeters or 7.7 inches, with a blade length of 8.5 centimeters or 3.35 inches, with a rather thick blade stock for a slender knife like this of 4 millimeters. And the steel here is M390 at a Rockwell hardness of 62 HRC. And then we have a hand length of 11 centimeters or 4.33 inches. And we have a weight of 81 grams or 2.82 ounces. Price-wise for this custom CNC machine knife, we're looking at around $850. Of course, it depends a bit on the different finishings you have, and of course of the model. I'm talking about the Model T at the moment. I can't speak for the Veli since I never had one of those. And this knife right here just is something very special once you hold it in the hand. The milling is very, very well done, really, really clean. You have this absolutely gorgeous custom pivot with the Hog House knives logo. Great anodizing, very consistent anodizing here on the green backspacer and screws. Nice kind of accordion style lock bar cutout. Same gorgeous milling on this very nicely designed pocket clip. This is a bit on the long side and is not touching the scale. That makes it very easy in and out of the pocket, but it's not the strongest retention. It never failed me while carrying and using, but just something to notice there. And of course we have a bit of a thicker blade stock, but coming down to a nice and thin cutting edge. Very well done, and we have some super fine micro milling on the blade. I hope the camera can pick that up. But you see there are some CNC machining lines on this kind of blasted main bevel, and then we have a hand-rubbed satin here on the flats, looking super, super high-end and clean. That is probably the best adjectives to actually describe this knife. It feels very high-end and clean and with some Nordic flair to it. It is a bit Puukko-inspired drop point blade shape. The thicker blade stock, of course, also comes from that. I like how the scale dips down here as well. We have some nice slotted screws, so easy to adjust. We have, of course, a very nicely executed lock bar cutout that is a bit on the thicker side, but they are working on that, so they have actually adjusted their milling to offer thinner lock bar cutouts, so they have kind of thinner bits now to address that, because some people complained about that or just mentioned that to them. We also see we have your number milled into the frame right there. Everything is nicely rounded. There's only one little area that can poke you a little bit while deploying the knife, and that is the utmost edge back here can poke you in the hand in certain ways of deploying the knife, because these are actual real kind of very sharp or kind of very acute corners. They are not sharp, you see the edges are broken, but because it is a bit of a more abrupt angle, those can poke you a bit in the hand while playing with the knife. The action is nice and smooth, free falling on the first drop, and then some light encouragement, we get it into the handle. So it's not a guillotine, but it's very, very smooth and controlled, a bit more on the hydraulic side. I really also love how it looks and plays with the light when it's closed. Perfectly centered, of course. Another little nitpick would be that there is no kind of sharpening choil. That is something that the makers don't really like. That was something that I would consider adding just for ease of actual use and maintenance. But it certainly looks very clean without the sharpening choil, and the original sharpening from the maker is really, really well done. Very sharp, very kind of thin kind of secondary bevel. Looks very, very clean. We have a good functional tip right there. And ergonomically, this is very well executed. You can also do a little bit of a foregrip, so you're really close to that cutting edge. But because it's part of the flipper tab, you can kind of pull back and feel quite secure while using this. There is no lock bar insert right there, as you can see. So it is a titanium frame lock. And it's just absolutely gorgeous and a very unique design. It's very, it stands on its own feet. It's not some kind of a homage or anything. This is really something they came up with their own, and it really shows where the knife comes from. I think it really exemplifies some Nordic features here. And it's also a knife that looks much larger than it actually is in pictures. And it still is very nice in the hand, nicely contoured, nicely rounded. The milling gives you some good traction while actually using the knife, and it carries so well because it is such a compact, overall slender form factor while actually carried in the pocket. Also, the pocket clip is mounted in a place where it's actually well done. There is a bit of knife sticking out, but because it's a longer, more slender knife, that really hasn't bothered me. And also in carry, these kind of corners also don't cause any issues in my carry, so that's certainly a nice thing. You also cannot touch the cutting edge here in the back. I would love to see some jimping here on the flipper tab, even though it's a very nicely executed flipper tab in terms of its design, but some jimping would just add a little bit more traction, and you wouldn't slip off at all. Just a very, very nice knife. In terms of detent, very crisp. It's not super strong, so you can fail it, as you have seen. If I don't give it any kind of power, you can fail it, but if you just do a regular light switch, it opens very reliably every time. And it's just very, very good looking, and especially in such a kind of toned down color combination, I think it really, really exemplifies the kind of milling prowess you're going to see here from Hog House Knives. Cutting performance is also very nice. You have a flat ground blade. Of course, if you have some very kind of hard materials, because of the thicker blade stock here, you can kind of tend to split things. But other than that, it's super, super sharp. It's a very nice steel. If the M390 had a great Rockwell hardness, and in terms of ergonomics while using it, there is no hotspot from the clip or anything. In a hammer grip, in a saber grip, it's very, very comfortable, and you have the option to kind of choke up a little bit on the flipper tab right there. And just the overall feel of the knife is very much high end. Also, in terms of kind of disengaging, you got that lock bar cutout or that chamfer on both sides. Not real cut away from the scale, but it's very easy to disengage that, as you have seen right there. Can just reach in there and push it to the side. Maybe some slight texturing here on this flat portion would have been nice as well. There is no additional internal milling, but you have seen the weight is actually very lightweight, and the balance is perfect in this kind of finger trail that you have right against your flipper tab. And now let's take a look at some other knives in the same kind of vein, and also some regular kind of size comparison that we do here on the channel. First off, we have the Shirogorov Neon Zero and the Shirogorov F95NL. And you can see it's much closer to a Neon Zero, but just much more slender in its overall execution. Then we have our Benchmark EDC blades. We have the Para 3 by Spyderco and the Benchmade full-sized bug out. And you can see it's a tiny bit larger than a full-sized bug out, and certainly larger than the Para 3. And if you take a look at thickness, we see, of course, we have 3D contour titanium handle scales, and the overall footprint is a bit thinner than a Para 3, which is certainly a nice thing. And of course, in pocket, this will carry much, much broader and much, much more awkward than the Hog House Knives Model T. And then some other very well executed CNC machined custom knives. You have here, for example, the Skiff Bladeworks Drifter, much, much more broad and heavy folder, but also amazing milling and very close in overall sizing. Then we have the Igor Olenikov Inspirer Short, absolutely gorgeous knife and also very close in overall sizing. But you can see it is very slender for its overall size. It's more slender than any of the knives I have shown you. And I think this gives it some kind of a Nordic elegance that is very hard to find in any other knife on the market at the moment. Then here we have the Rob Johnson's Cypress from Latvia, also one of these more Nordic countries in Europe. And you can see it is a bit larger than that one as well. And this is even a bit broader. And this still is a very, very easy to carry, lightweight, and quite slender and thin knife. So it's very interesting that everything is still broader than the Hog House Knives Model T right here. So in that sense, it really is a unique design, and it's executed really well by these Finnish custom knife makers. And it's cool to see new companies like this and see what they come up with. Another little kind of nitpick or thing I would love to see is a kind of non-milled spot underneath the pocket clip, but because it's not really kind of touching, I don't think it's not that big of an issue because you don't have that much tension there. But those are all very little nitpicks. Overall, I'm very happy with this knife, and I'm very happy to support some European knife makers and show off their quality here. And just overall, very impressive knife, and something that I see staying in the collection for quite a long time. Absolutely gorgeous. The kind of thing that I would like to see most is probably a sharpening choil and maybe a slightly thinner blade, just in terms of usability or improved cutting performance. But I certainly can see the design aspect of those thicker blade stocks here, and that is also something that certainly could be a trade-off for some. So absolutely gorgeous knife, very cool guys to deal with, and certainly a company to keep an eye out with all their new finishes, the new model that they have now released with the Veli. If you like larger knives and broader knives, that is certainly also a nice knife to look at. But overall, very well executed here from Viljami Salonen and Tapio Syrjälä. And I hope you liked the video. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, put them down in the comment section below. And follow me here on YouTube as well as on Instagram at 7ready_knife_reviews. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.